you action figure enthusiasts out there, JC here with another TNI news video. And we've got a lot of things to cover going back to last week, so let's jump right into it. And let's start off with Star Wars. Today, of course, is May 4th, the official Star Wars Day. May the 4th be with you. And with that, Hasbro held a live stream event where they showed off some new products for Star Wars. So let's go over what they revealed today. Now, I will tell you, for those of you who are possibly keeping track, they announced a total of 9 new store exclusives. And then they also, for non-store exclusives, we got a whole 3 vintage collection figures announced. But a total of 9 brand new store exclusives were announced today. And then, like I said, 3 non-exclusives. That's kind of where we're going. It seems like with Hasbro, where regardless of the line, G.I. Joe, Star Wars, what have you, you know, everything is becoming a store exclusive, generally to either Walmart or Target. So, you know, think about that next time you run to Target or Walmart to buy non-store exclusives. If you're not happy with that situation, you know, maybe you should perhaps, even if it's a little more convenient to buy them at Target or Walmart, you know, think about, you know, supporting the small guy, because the more you support the big box retailers, the more you're essentially allowing them to have a grip hold on the industry, which is why I think we're seeing all these exclusives. Okay, so what was revealed today for Star Wars? So first of all, we got for the 9 exclusives, again, it was 3 vintage collection figures. So they showed off that they are doing another one of the original 96 figures, another Ewok Tebow, he's coming to the line again, vintage collection, and these will be up for pre-order by tomorrow, 1 p.m. Eastern time. Pretty much everything that was announced today is going up for pre-order tomorrow, which is Revenge of the Fifth. Gotta love marketing. And then the other 2 vintage collection figures were an off-world Jawa figure from the Mandalorian TV series. So we were already getting one of those with, if you back the HasLab Razor Crest, well, now you're getting a general release of the character. It will come with the egg, like we saw in the first season episode. So we're getting that one. And then the final one is Echo, one of the clones. So he is the 3rd figure that was announced. And again, that will be available everywhere, including places like our sponsor, Big Bad Toy Store. Now, besides that, besides those 3, again, everything else pretty much announced was either something they just teased and so we don't know how it's going to be released, or it's an actual store exclusive. So starting off with GameStop, the Gaming Greats line for Black Series, they announced a new Flame Trooper as well as the Knight Brother Order figure. So these are based on the video games. Again, here in the U.S. will be GameStop exclusive. In Canada will be released at EB Games. And then I believe UK will see releases at certain retailers and Hasbro Pulse. So those are the 2 Gaming Great figures that were announced. And again, these should be going up for pre-order tomorrow on the GameStop website. Then for Walmart exclusives, based on the new Bad Batch animated series, which premiered today, which actually was pretty good. I watched it. It was like an hour and 17 minute episode. And overall, I thought it was pretty good. But they announced 2 new figures there. So a Shock Trooper, which, you know, we've seen them before, but this is technically based on their appearance in the Bad Batch animated series, the Red Clone Troopers, you know, essentially that hung out with Palpatine usually. And then the 2nd figure was Vice Admiral Rampart. Now, one of these 2 figures, I believe, is actually already listed on the Walmart website. It went up for pre-order yesterday. But Walmart has not included any images, and they're still using, they haven't actually named the figure. So I'm making an assumption that this is one of the 2 Walmart exclusive figures that was announced today. It's listed with a September 1st release date. It's going to cost $25 because it is a store exclusive. So I'll put a link to that in the video description below, and you can roll the dice. Okay, now jumping over to the 50th anniversary vintage collection. So these will also be Walmart exclusives. And with these, we are getting the Death Star droid and Endor Luke with his poncho and a new Tusken Raider figure. So these, again, will be Walmart exclusives, part of the vintage collection line. And again, should be going up for pre-order sometime tomorrow, I think around 1 o'clock p.m. Eastern time. The final exclusive that they announced today was a roleplay item. They are doing the Death Watch Mandalorian helmet. So, you know, essentially a redeco of their Boba Fett helmet made to look like the Death Watch from the Clone Wars animated series and such. This will be a GameStop exclusive and, again, will be going up for pre-order tomorrow. They showed off a new image for the Razor Crest today. And then the final two things, which they didn't really show us actual product for, but they announced that also getting the Black Series treatment is the character Omega, who is a new character that appeared in the Bad Batch episode. She is a young girl character. And then the other thing they announced was the winner of their recent Vintage Collection fan vote. So the winner of that and getting an updated figure will be the Republic Trooper from the old Republic video game. So you'll see, you know, it'll have a photoreal deco paint apps to it, and also will have a little bit updated packaging. And that should be on shelf sometime next year. Now, I know a lot of people of you have been asking about when those Target exclusive retro Black Series Clone Wars figures that were announced the other week by Hasbro, when would they actually be going up for pre-order on the Target website here in the United States. They are Target exclusives, and in Canada, they're Toys R Us exclusives. I believe today they went up on the Toys R Us Canada website, but as far as Target, Hasbro has not specifically said, but I'm guessing we'll probably see those go up tomorrow along with everything else. Okay, now let's jump over to Marvel. So yesterday was the first Monday of the month. If you caught my live stream on Sunday, I gave you a heads up of what this reveal was going to be. It is one of the Infinity Saga figures, specifically the Age of Ultron Quicksilver figure, which is available for pre-order now at places like our sponsor Big Bad Toy Store. It is going to come with multiple hands as well as some drone parts, you know, from the Age of Ultron movie. So, I don't know. This figure, to me, the face likeness just seems a little bit off. It's not horrible, but it's not as good as a lot of the recent face decos from the MCU line that Hasbro's done. So, maybe the final version will look a little better here, but I'm just not totally sold on the face sculpt with this figure. But I'd love to hear your thoughts. You know, what do you think about it? Now, because this is part of that subline, the figure does cost more. It's running at about $25, $26. And we saw that a very similar thing with the price increase with the 80th anniversary subline, which is what this Infinity Saga is essentially a continuation of. Now, I will tell you that May is going to be a big month. Throughout the month, I don't think there's going to necessarily be a full-on one day of reveals, though they might do something during the month, a live stream, another live stream. But I will tell you that throughout the month, on various days, there are going to be new products going up for pre-order and such. We should probably be seeing the remaining figures in the Infinity Saga line, which there's a total of 10, three of which should be store exclusives. I've talked about all those before, so I'm not going to go down the entire list. But I do expect that we will get those all fully revealed this month, and then there should be a couple other things as well. So get your wallets ready, and you know, like I said, May is going to be a big month for Marvel. Now, real quick on the G.I. Joe front. So just today, Hasbro finally officially acknowledged the G.I. Joe classified Major Blood figure. So I've talked about this figure before, and we have seen the figure pop up on eBay a few weeks ago. We've even seen some reviewers get their hands on it, probably from the person on eBay, I don't know. But Hasbro has finally at least officially acknowledged the existence of the G.I. Joe classified Major Blood figure, which is a Cobra Island figure, which means it will be some type of Target store exclusive. Now here's the kicker. The Target systems, this figure has been in the Target systems. It is showing with an arrival date at stores on or around May 19th this month. However, in the announcement today that Hasbro put out on their social media when they released this image of the Blood figure, they stated that they weren't going to be giving details on how the figure was going to be released until June. So, I don't know if that means that Hasbro is making the official release date of the figure in June. I know Hasbro is doing this big promotional thing for June, Yojo June, I think is what they're calling it. I think they're going to have a live stream sometime in June where they're going to be revealing more classified product. And it looks like they're trying to hold this Blood figure until then. I, however, don't think that's going to go very well, because if this figure is going to start arriving at Target stores any day now, and again, all indications are that that is going to be the case, even if there's an embargo date placed on the figure of sometime in June, as we saw with like the figures in the first wave, that did not go well. A lot of Targets would start, you know, selling them early. They didn't pay attention to the release date. Then people would go in and other Targets would tell them that they couldn't sell them. Then the dates changed and Targets didn't get the memo. And it was just in a complete clusterfuck with the first wave. So I feel like that's where we're headed with this, that the major blood figure is going to start showing up at Target stores in the back room. Maybe even already, I don't know, but definitely around that kind of May 19th time frame. And then again, if Hasbro is planning on trying to wait until June to release this figure, you know, it's going to be a lot of frustration the way I see it. Something that's already frustrating just because it is a Target exclusive. Now, I know some people are hoping that Hasbro is going to make these available also on their Pulse website. You know, 2 weeks ago, they put up the Cobra Island Viper and the Firefly figure. Of course, it only lasted for 3 minutes, and that was only making it available to their, you know, what I consider to be somewhat of a ridiculous $50 premium price thingamabob. You know, it was only made to those premium members, and it sold out in 3 minutes. And supposedly it was only available one per person, but again, those sold out in 3 minutes. So even people who had paid their $50 premium price, you know, unless they happened to be online that very second it was announced, you know, they weren't able to get the figure. In fact, a lot of people said they got the email that Hasbro sent out, which was basically, to me, seemed like was just trying to get people to join their premium service. But even those people who had already been premium members, when they got the email and they clicked on the link and it went to the site, the figures were already sold out. So even if they do make the major blood figure available on the Pulse website in some limited fashion, I find it hard to believe it's really going to be that beneficial to most people. I refuse to pay $50 for the privilege of possibly being able to buy a company's product. You know, I know some people will try and tell you it's worth the money. I don't buy it, so I refuse to join their premium dollars. If they did make the figure available to anybody who wanted it, had enough available on the Pulse website so that anybody who wanted it, premium or non-premium, you know, and it didn't sell out in like 3 minutes, that would be a good thing. But I really find it hard to believe, based on the track record that we've been seeing with these things, that that's actually how it would go. So it would be nice if Hasbro took a page from, like, say, NECA and started just doing the pre-orders, you know, kind of like they did with their San Diego Comic-Con or PulseCon exclusives last year. You know, if they just made it for pre-order, I don't mind waiting a little bit longer to get the figure, as long as I don't have to go through 50 million hoops to get them like I have with the previous Cobra Island figures. You know, I'm good for it. If they even want to make it available on Target and they actually want to have Target carry enough of them so that they're widely available, I'm all for that as well. But again, I'm not holding my breath on that. And if these end up hitting Target stock rooms, you know, in the next week or so, but they can't be officially sold until next month, I just feel like, you know, that's just another, another big frustration waiting for the consumer in a line that has been filled with almost nothing but frustration. So, and then for Transformers, last week we got a reveal for a Transformers Shattered Glass Megatron figure. So this is available for pre-order on the Hasbro Pulse website. It is slated for release on October 1st and is going to cost you $29.99. Okay, now let's jump over to NECA. So going back to last Tuesday, it's been a week. I did the last news video on Monday, so this is kind of old news, but I did want to go over it since I haven't talked about it in a video, other than we did talk about it briefly in the live stream. But last Tuesday, NECA went on and released official images and put up for pre-order that Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle movie April O'Neil figure based on the Judith Hogue actress, and you know, that they've been showing off teasers for and everything for the last several weeks. So that figure did go up for pre-order on the NECA website. Now, this figure will be offered at Walmart. It is a Walmart exclusive, but if you don't want to deal with Walmart, you had last week and this week, you've got about a week to go if you want to pre-order the figure. Now, the regular figure costs $30 on the NECA website, And then they also offered this limited edition autograph version that they were selling for $100 that included an exclusive raincoat, you know, the raincoat that she wore for like 2 seconds in the movie that was kind of a nod to her yellow jumpsuit. And that one sold out in seconds. Again, it was limited to 2,000 pieces. And that one, I personally feel like anyone who paid $100 for that, unless you're just like just a diehard Judith Hogue fan who just needed to have her autograph, you know, I think you're crazy. But of course, you know, scarcity marketing wins again, and it sold out in seconds, though it's unclear to me whether it was scalpers who bought them all up or actual collectors. I really don't know. But that one has since sold out. So definitely that seemed to irritate a lot of people as far as not being able to get the raincoat. And then, you know, also I've been seeing people kind of knock this figure for the knees, which I don't collect the movie stuff, so, you know, I'm not really going to say. Now, one thing I also want to note, when they released images for April, they gave us our first real look at the unmasked Casey Jones figure. So they still have not yet announced how that figure is going to be released. But we can see there is definitely an unmasked Casey Jones figure in the works from NECA, and hopefully details will be coming soon on that one. NECA also released their first images of their upcoming life-size Chucky doll from Child's Play. So these are, you know, in production, behind-the-scenes type images. But again, it's our first look at that life-size Chucky figure that was announced sometime last year. I forget exactly when they first announced it was coming. But I know a lot of people have been waiting to see it. So they say more reveals will be coming, you know, in the near future. So stay tuned for that. NECA just today showed off some new images for their Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Deluxe Animated Series Muckman and Joe Eyeball figure set. And they say this will start hitting shelves next month in June. Now, while we're on the subject of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, I also wanted to tell you about some new figures coming from an overseas company. This is actually said to be a joint collaboration between companies Snapfinger Animation and Heat Boys. I'm not really familiar with any of these companies. Again, they are from overseas. But these do appear to be officially licensed product from Nickelodeon. And these guys are going to be doing mech turtles. So mechs are the new big thing, and the turtles are getting the mech treatment. They're doing the four turtles, which are made to look like mech suits of armor. I'm not sure the exact scale on these figures, but I'm thinking they are bigger than 7-inch figures, but again, I don't have those details at this time. They did have a prototype on display at an exhibition overseas. And, so we're getting our first look at an actual prototype for one of the turtles. Looks like Leonardo. And then they've shown concept art for the other three turtles, as well as they're doing Shredder. So when more details like pricing and how these will actually be sold or where these will be sold become available, I'll be sure to pass that information on to you guys. On the McFarlane toy front, we got some images that surfaced online, some scans. I don't know if the original source is the Shock and Awe toy reviews, but that's where I saw who had posted them up. And with these scans, we're getting our first look at two of the new Witcher figures. These are based on the video game, not the TV series. So Ciri, I guess is how you say her name. Sorry, I'm not super familiar with the character, but... So if I mispronounce it, I apologize, but one of the female characters. And then another one of the versions of the main character, which is listed as his wolf armor, and we've seen overseas listings for that, but some people have indicated that this is not actually his wolf armor. So I don't know if that's a mislabeling. Manticore is what people are saying this is actually based on. So I'm not familiar enough with the game to know, and you know, but it's listed as wolf armor. You can see in the scans and everything. So we'll have to see how the final version is actually listed. And then we've also got some images for upcoming Warhammer 40,000 figures, new figures on that front. With the Necron Flayed one, with both a regular version and an artist-proof version, and then the Battle Sister, the Order of the Bloody Rose figure. So Those, again, I've seen pre-order listings, overseas pre-order listings for these figures before. We've got these magazine scans. They have not yet been officially announced by McFarlane Toys, but those details will hopefully come soon. And then for you folks who've been collecting the My Hero Academia figures from McFarlane Toys, thanks to a heads up from MCU Collector, we've gotten word that there is a Platinum Edition version of the All For One character. So he ordered the regular version on Amazon's website and ended up getting sent this Platinum Edition version, which essentially looks like has the face blacked out completely. That seems to be the main difference. But just something to be on the lookout. You know, these Platinum Edition figures are essentially being released as chase-type figures. So if you're ordering them online, it's always possible you could end up with one of those as opposed to the regular version. And again, according to MCU Collector, he ordered this off of Amazon. And then finally, for you Masters of the Universe fans, we've got some new package images for some of the Masterverse figures. For the figures in the line have shown up. I'm not sure of the original source. They appear to be some type of in-hand images, but I don't know what the original source for these images were. They just started floating around the internet. So the four figures that we're seeing here are He-Man, Skeletor, Mossman, and Evil Lyn. All of these should cost around $24.99 here in the United States. Now, based on the information I have seen, that these figures, these Masterverse figures, will start showing up at Walmart stores first. And I was told several months ago that June would be the time frame that they would start showing up at Walmart. So could even be sooner, being that somebody has gotten these in hand. But I would expect probably these four figures will be the ones that end up showing up at Walmart first. Now, we've seen listings through the overseas retailer Zavvi for other figures in the line, which include Spikor, Teela, Man-at-Arms, Beastman, and then an oversized Skeletor and Battlecat. So the oversized Skeletor had a price of $30 and the Battlecat had a price of $40. And, you know, Walmart's getting first crack, and my guess is it'll probably just be the first four figures. And then a month or so later, by August or September, everyone should be carrying the figures, including places like our sponsor, Big Bad Toy Store. There's also a Revelation prequel comic book limited series coming. So, you know, these are all based on the new upcoming Netflix series that's being done by Kevin Smith. The Masterverse figures, as well as this comic book prequel series. Now, this prequel series is being written by Kevin Smith and is being put out by Dark Horse Comics. And these are the covers for the first issue. So the Mike Mignola cover is a variant cover, and the first issue is slated for release, should hit comic and specialty shops on July 7th. And then finally, for Masters of the Universe, I just wanted to share these new in-hand images of the Wave 6 Fakor and Fisto figures. I told you about these before. We had seen some package images recently surface online, but now somebody's actually gotten their hands on these. So these images come via Retro Toy Escapades, who's actually done some video reviews for both figures. So I will put a link to their channel in the video description below. But I just, the images that surfaced previously didn't give us a good look at the Fakor figure, and they were just package images, so I want to go on and share these. You know, these are basically the two new figures in the wave. The other figures, repaint of Evil Lyn, and then that power conversion of Merman are the other two figures that round out Wave 6. And it looks like, I'm guessing, Wave 6 is actually going to hit shelves before Wave 5, since we haven't even seen images for Wave 5 yet. And Wave 5 should have Stinkor, Webstore, a second version of Beastman, and then the Green Goddess character. So again, I suspect that Wave 6 is actually going to hit shelves before we see Wave 5. Okay, so that's it for today. I'd love to hear your thoughts on everything I talked about. Let me know in the comments section below. Subscribe to the channel, like the video. Stay safe out there, guys, and until next time, I'll catch you later. Hey, thanks for watching today's video, and be sure to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and hit that bell notification so alerted every time I upload a new video. And be sure to head over to the Toy News International and Marvelous News message boards communities. It's a great place to talk toys and win cool contests like $100 store credits to Big Bad Toy Store. And remember, action figures are great!